Welcome to UCAN Design-It, introductory training video for concrete anchoring design. This tutorial explains the basic use of our program. Let's get started. After downloading the Design-It software from the UCAN website, open the downloaded setup application by either right-clicking the app, or double-clicking. When warned about unrecognized app, click Run Anyway, and then follow the screen prompts. Once you have successfully installed the software, click on the Design-It icon to launch the software. Accept the disclaimer. Open a new project, or if you wish to work on a saved project, open that project. Select the units for the input and calculation, metric for Canada or imperial for US design. Note, you can toggle between metric and imperial anytime. Select the language for input and reporting. The Canadian flag indicates English. Select the code which the design is based on, CSA 23.3 for Canada, or ACI 318 for US projects. Choose the type of concrete, cracked or uncracked. Indicate concrete strength, preset imperial values, or user defined. If user defined is chosen, input the concrete compressive strength. If supplementary reinforcement is present, input edge reinforcement, tension and shear loading particulars. Select hole drilling method, concrete condition, and concrete type, typical is normal weight. Temperature is only for adhesive anchors depending on the loading condition. Select standoff installation condition if applicable, with necessary particulars. Pick the type of load, for example, static or seismic. In this example, static has been chosen. The design load option indicates that you have entered factored loads. If load factors option is designated, you may enter your application specific load and load factors. The program will calculate the factored loads and will use this information after you click on the Take Over Design Load button. Enter all applicable loads. Please observe loading directions in the X, Y, and Z axis directions. You may use table input or 3D image. At the bottom of the 3D image, you may turn detail off and on. Once you click on a value, you may enter the data. Input edge distance conditions. You may use the 3D image, or use the input table option. In this example, there is one edge distance condition. Enter the data in the table. For the moment, ignore the edge distance warning in the results section. It may be resolved after anchor selection is completed. Continue to input the application details. Input base plate details geometry. There is an option of either 2D table or 3D input. Choose the 2D table input and enter the data into the table. Determine profiles if applicable, steel structures attached to the base plate, for example, columns or beam. This project has a square HSS post. Choose profile, then select profile data and click OK. Set the anchor group. This sample application uses two anchors. Input anchor spacing using the 3D image for the data entry. You have completed the application-specific data input and are ready to select the anchor. In this instance, choose the UCAN Heavy Load Anchor. Select anchor material, anchor type, and thread type. Internal thread refers to the hex bolt type heavy load anchor. Product visuals illustrate all anchors included in the program. Do not click on an image to choose an anchor. Rather, pick an anchor from the selection options. Populate the anchor diameter and the embedment field, unless it is grayed out. Since the heavy load anchor is a metric size anchor, choose 16 indicating a 16mm anchor size. Select the anchors shown in the list below. The fastener choices reflect your designated anchor and diameter input. SZS indicates the hex bolt type and SZB the threaded stud type heavy load anchor. For this application, choose the hex bolt type anchor. First, resolve the warning in red, indicating that the selected anchoring does not meet the spacing requirements related to anchor size and embedment. Go back to edge distance input and enter 120 mm. This will clear the warning. The results also indicate that the base plate thickness was not calculated. To resolve this, go back to the base plate section. Click on the rigid base plate, then click the triangle icon to run the base plate design identifying the thickness. Accept the selected thickness to transfer this dimension to the report. The elastic base plate calculation will be available later as an optional add-on. For details about this method, click on the I button. If you are satisfied with your input results, go to the results field and click on the printer icon. Enter information on the designer and the application or project. This information will show on the report. Once the project details have been inputted, select Print Report. The report is generated in a Microsoft-compatible file which you can save for your records or for future distribution to clients. Click on the Export XPS file button to save the file in this format. Save the file for future use. You can open it to review and adjust design particulars if required. We hope you have enjoyed this introduction video to UCAN Design-It software. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel to receive new video notifications.